arruman tela, con tela, sin tela, vámonos a gozar. A la rumba en tela, con tela, sin tela, para rumbear.
Sweetheart outside about 5 minutes ago. Still thinking about that ivory tickler, huh?
More than ever.
Oh, why don't you marry him so you can forget him?
Oh, Isabelita.
Yes.
How do you like the arrangement for your new song?
I like it very much.
Good.
Call for you, Mr. Jones.
I'll be right there. Make it an especially good performance tonight. Hey, Isabelita, we have a big crowd.
I'll try my best, Mr. Charles.
All right, madam.
What this place needs is a good first aid station.
Don't they ever get tired coming here? Every night, the same food, same faces, same entertainment.
They don't come here for the entertainment, honey.
This is the clearinghouse for their gossip.
The small talk tonight will be the scandal in tomorrow's paper.
Oh, don't you ever get fed up with it all, Hetty?
I can't afford to. These women tell me more than they tell their husbands.
But I get good tips for listening.
Well, my job isn't worth the money. Every time one of these guys gives me a quarter tip, he thinks it makes him a licensed chiropractor.
That's one trouble I haven't had yet.
And when I'm not fencing off passes, I'm walking my feet to the bone. My next job is going to be demonstrating wheelchairs.
Sometimes I wonder what genius thought of the idea of this glamorous nightlife.
Oh, some glamour. A lot of married dames playing footsie under the table with somebody else's husband.
What'd you have to run your hands through his hair for?
Well, how'd I know he wore a toupee?
That. Leave it to that one to frame an alibi.
Well, I can't understand how a nice girl like Julia got mixed up with a heel like him. Do you think he killed her?
Who knows?
Jimmy.
Don't sneak up on me like that.
What's wrong with you, Jimmy?
Nothing's wrong with me. I'm just getting a little fresh air.
Well, you've been acting all day as if you're scared about something. What is it, Jimmy? Jimmy!
Go with me.
You've got a gun.
Keep quiet, will you?
What are you up to, Jimmy?
Don't ask me about the gun, honey. I can't talk about it now.
All right, be stubborn about it if you want to. I'll get somebody else to take me home after the show.
Don't be unreasonable, darling. I'll explain everything if you'll give me time.
Well, you better start right now. After all, if you haven't done anything, we'll have to carry a gun.
I haven't done anything. Honest, I haven't.
All right, have it your own way.
Isabelita!
Back again?
Why, I feel so conspicuous waiting out there.
Well, here, make yourself comfortable. Sit down, have a cigarette.
I came early because I'm meeting a gentleman.
I didn't want to keep him waiting on my first date with him.
I understand.
Suppose he's late. Suppose he doesn't show up at all.
Oh, he'll show up all right. They always do.
He certainly seemed anxious enough to make the date. Do you like my dress?
It's awfully pretty, miss.
It's a model. I got it at cost where I work. $59.50. Without alterations.
No.
Uh-huh. Even that's more than I can afford, but... well, maybe it'll be a good investment. It must cost plenty to bring a girl here.
It certainly does, honey.
Maybe I should have suggested a cheaper place. You see, he's still an intern.
Nice seeing you again, Mrs. Littlefair. We missed you.
I've been away, Charles. Tell me, has Mr. Norton arrived yet?
I believe he's at the bar.
Thank you. Hello, Johnny.
Well, Roz?
You don't seem very glad to see me.
Why didn't you wire me before you got on the train?
I was too confused, I guess. All I could think of was getting back to you as fast as I could.
Your message came this afternoon, so I had to break an important business engagement to be with you.
I'm sorry, darling. I didn't think anything could be more important than seeing you.
Sure.
Good evening, Mr. Rogers.
Good evening, Charles.
You have a reservation for 5, I believe. The usual table.
Oh, Charles. I have a chance to put over a big deal tonight, and, well, I need a little cooperation.
You mean you want to sign again?
That's it, Charles. Only for a couple of days, and I'll pay all the other tabs.
I don't know. You see, I...
Honest, Charles, this time it's only for a couple of days.
Well, all right, Mr. Rogers.
Thanks, Charles. You're a gentleman.
What was that, Charles? He looks awfully familiar.
Henry, who is that man?
That's Clifton Rogers, the promoter.
Clifton Rogers.
Clifton Rogers. He's worth millions.
Good evening, Mrs. Rogers.
Good evening.
Mr. Quinn.
Good evening, Charles.
Two.
Just two, Charles.
Henry, number 17 for Mr. Quinn, Mrs. Locke.
I guess, Charles, right this way, please.
Let's have a drink, huh?
All right. Order one of our specials while I powder my nose. I'll only be a minute.
How are you?
Hello, Mrs. Lineker.
Not Mrs. Lineker anymore.
No.
I just got back from Reno. I'm free, Hetty, free.
Oh, I'm awfully glad.
At last I can marry Mr. Norton.
How wonderful. If anyone deserves happiness, you do.
Thank you.
She just got rid of one husband, and she's expecting to get another one.
She was married to a drunken brute.
Before I marry, I'm going to think it over for days.
Sometimes when love comes along, you can't do much thinking. And here's a little tip, honey. When you order tonight, remember, young interns can't afford girls with big appetites, especially in a place like this.
Do you think he'd bring me here if he couldn't afford?
Well, you bought a dress you couldn't afford.
Here. Oh, am I all right?
No, take it easy. You'll think you're too anxious.
I'll wait till he's not looking, and then I'll pretend I just got here.
Take it easy.
Hello, Lucy.
Sorry I'm late.
I just got here myself. I was detained at the hospital.
Oh. An operation?
An emergency.
Gosh, I hope you didn't rush it because of me.
Well, don't worry about that, Lucy. All I did was stand by and help the surgeon.
Dr. Porter.
Good evening, Doctor. Yes, we have your reservation.
How about a drink at the bar?
I'd love it.
You had me worried for a minute when I didn't see you.
I wouldn't break a date with you, Bill.
Your gown's very becoming.
You like it?
Yes, I do. What are you drinking?
You do the ordering.
Two Bacardis, please.
Here's to us. Darling, your drink. You're not drinking what we always have together.
I've been on martinis lately.
Well, don't sound so defiant. There's no law against them.
Your table is ready, Mr. Norton.
Oh, thank you. Come on, Roz.
He's the cuckoo in my class. And when he says cuckoo, he means it's time to woo with Tico time for all the loafers in the block. I've got a heavy day, da ta da ta da hey. So Spico Tico, tell me it is getting late. If I'm on time, cuckoo, but if I'm late, woo-hoo, the one my heart is going to may not want to wait. For just a birdie, I'm a birdie who goes nowhere. Of every lover's lane and how to go there. For in affairs of the heart, my Tico's terribly smart. He tells me gently, sentimentally at the start. Oh, I hear my little Tico, Tico calling. Because the time is right and shades of night are falling. I love the not so cuckoo, cuckoo in the clouds. Tico, 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 Tico tico ti, mi tico tico ta, mi tico tico ta cantando mi reló. Si voy a vacilar, me sale a avisar que mi negrita está esperando en el solar. Mi tico tico ti, mi tico tico ta, mi tico tico ta cantando mi reló. Si voy a vacilar, me sale a avisar que mi negrita está esperando en el solar. Y cuando salgo con mi negro ranchando, tico tico me despierto bien temprano. Mi pajarito está cantando cuando salgo, pues cuando salgo solo está cantando. Y cuando salgo con mi negro ranchando, mi tico tico me despierto bien temprano. Y cuando salgo con mi negro ranchando, tico 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 tico. Tico 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 tico.
Have the gayest crowd. I feel completely young when I come to the Club Havana.
You're very kind, madame. Mr. Rogers is waiting.
Ah, good, good. And Senior Molinas, oh, such charm, such personality. You know, I've always had a secret desire to have a romance with that man.
Oh.
No, really, quite seriously. I feel that a man who understands music must understand women.
Good evening, Mrs. Cavendish.
Ah, Cliffy. And we're like delicate instruments, you know. And it's the way we wear a handle which makes us produce either harmonies or discords. Strange. When I'm emotionally stirred, I always develop the most tremendous appetite. I think I'll have a steak. Yes, a large one.
And two bottles of Paul Roger. The 28.
Very well, sir.
Steak.
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 Chicken sandwich. I told you I was sorry, darling.
Well, at least you could tell me what it's all about. Don't you trust me?
Of course I trust you, dear. It's just something I had to work out for myself.
Everybody thinks I have an interest in the place.
Well, what's wrong? What are you staring at?
I thought Joe Reed was in jail.
They let him out. He had an alibi.
Don't you read the papers?
I didn't see a paper. What was his alibi?
He said he wasn't even in town the night Julia was murdered.
Don't turn around. He'll know we're talking about it.
What are you so jumpy about?
The night of the murder, Julia got home a little after I did. You know how you can hear through the walls in our hotel.
What are you trying to say, Jimmy?
The cops say she was killed about 4 o'clock. They're right, I heard the shot.
What?
A few minutes later, I saw Joe Reed coming down the fire escape with a gun in his hand.
Well, did he see you?
I don't think so. I was scared stiff, but when the cops grabbed him, I thought they had the goods on him. I figured I could keep my mouth shut and I wouldn't get messed up in it.
Jimmy, listen to me. You must keep quiet about this.
I can't. Gotta do something about this, Marina. I've gotta tell the police.
But Jimmy, if he finds out...
I think I can do it without his finding out. We'll talk about it later.
Showing himself in public is Reed's way of thumbing his nose at the murder charge.
Yes, but I wish he'd picked out some other cafe.
Having a good time?
Oh, wonderful. Isn't this a beautiful place?
I never realized how much I was passing up. You know, this is the first time I've been to a nightclub since I left college.
I thought you went all the time.
Too busy. Serving an internship is hard work and no pay. Besides, I never knew any girls.
What about all those pretty nurses I've heard about?
The doctor doesn't like to be reminded of disinfectants all the time.
Just think, if you hadn't walked into the shop that day, we wouldn't be here together now.
Want to dance?
So I don't see how my proposition can fail to return big profits on the money invested. How does it strike you, Mrs. Cavendish?
It sounds very interesting, the way you tell it.
Then, why not come in on it with me?
I never put my money in other people's schemes. It's a principle with me. Whatever I invest in, I control.
Well, I'd be willing to let you buy the controlling interest.
That wouldn't be fair to you. It's your idea. Besides, I have so many interests requiring all my time now that I prefer to dispose of some rather than add any more. You are disappointed.
Very much. But only because I thought it would be such a pleasant association.
Wait. I have a counter offer. Children, eat. I've buried 3 husbands. The first was an old man. He left me a large fortune. After that, I could afford to marry for love.
Yes?
However, I'm no longer romantically inclined. Love? I'm much too wealthy. Children, eat. But it is convenient to be married.
Convenient?
The companionship means much when one has grown more mellow. And the masculine point of view is often important. Besides, I enjoy the comfort of having someone buy the tickets, drive my cars, escort me wherever I want to go.
Yes, I see.
For you, such an alliance would be ideal.
For me?
Your pleasure is making money. Mine is keeping it. You have no capital. I have millions.
Millions?
So this is what I propose. We will marry. I will finance your schemes. You will handle all the business. The dispersing of money will be my department.
You mean I'll be free to operate with all the capital I need?
Under my supervision.
It's the best proposition I've had in years.
Then you accept my proposal?
Most heartily, my dear.
I thought it would appeal to you.
Of course.
Children, that's the way Mama does it.
Yes, Mama.
What's wrong, Johnny?
Why, nothing, Ross. Nothing.
What is wrong, Johnny?
Let's get it over, darling, before it spoils our evening.
It's hard to know how to say it.
It shouldn't be. Not to me.
That's what makes it so difficult. You've been swell.
Johnny, that is a strange ring of the past tense about it.
I'm afraid that's the way it is for me. We always said we'd be honest with each other, didn't we? Roz, I feel terrible about it. Before you went away, I was happy with things as they were. I didn't see anything but the stars. Now?
Now there's another face in the stars.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Very. She's a... I don't know, I can't explain it.
It means... I can't even fight for you.
I wish it hadn't happened. But it's just one of those things, I guess.
I know. I suppose I shouldn't be so stunned. I've seen lots of romances go smash. It's the kind of thing you see happening to others, but you just never think they could happen to you.
Please, Ross, don't.
It's all right, darling. I'll get hold of myself. Only it's hard to do it just like that. Don't tell me I can't even snap my fingers. There. You see? I did it.
Roz.
Around the corner from my apartment, there's a darling little ivy-covered church. And every time I passed it, I used to plan. Our wedding there, and be happily ever after. Anything that doesn't include you, darling, just doesn't make sense. I think I'll go and see if my hair's turned white. Order some more wine, will you, darling? At least tonight is mine.
Mr. Finnegan, what happened?
Did it show me as much as that, Hattie?
And your dress.
Oh, it's just some champagne.
But champagne will leave a spot if you don't wash it out. It'll just take a minute. Oh, I'm sorry, Mrs. Cavendish. You were saying...
This will be my husband, I think. He's rather stupid, but we'll get along. And he goes well with my early American furniture. Yes, he goes very well with the furniture. Ah, well, I shan't need those sleeping pills any longer.
Oh, do you have insomnia?
Yes, but when I can't sleep at night now, at least I'll have a partner for gin rummy. Oh, money's a wonderful asset. That's all a woman needs, to compete with beauty, it seems. If she has money. And if she has enough.
What a character. May I have a glass of water, Hetty?
Oh, certainly.
Thank you.
Thank you, Eddie. Mrs. Lineker, this is $20.
Buy yourself something to remember me by.
You want to leave now, Rose?
Let's stay a little while longer, do you mind?
Of course not.
And let's have one last glass of champagne together, shall we?
Why not?
Mr. and Mrs. Kingston.
Good evening, Charles.
Your table is waiting for you. This way, please.
Thank you.
It is a pleasure to have you with us again.
I suppose he means together.
No doubt. You know, I haven't been here more than twice since our separation.
Really? I've been here quite often.
Oh, I hated the sight of the place. On account of the memories.
Oh, so did I. Thank you, Charles. Only, I did come once in a while. See if you were here.
Darling.
Darling. We'd be ridiculously sentimental.
Maybe so, but I like it. You always did make me feel sentimental, Susan.
Not always.
No, no. We promised to let bygones be bygones.
I'm sorry.
Oh, it's gay here tonight.
Now, don't interrupt them for a while. I don't think they're interested in food at the moment.
You're quite old to be romancing.
Oh, they've been husband and wife for 11 years.
Really, monsieur?
Yes. They were separated about a year ago, but now I think they're going to be reconciled.
Habits are hard to break. Mrs. Van.
I wonder what we'd do if we ever met. What did we just say? Hello, Willie. Hello, Susie. Very casually, and then pass by. Or would we pretend not to see each other?
I know. That worried me a lot, too.
And then I did see you once.
You did? Where?
At the theater. You were with a foreign-looking fellow.
That must have been Orlando. Or maybe Andre. I didn't see you.
My ducks wouldn't. I felt kind of sick and lost inside.
Oh, darling.
You know, darling, even when I was hating you the most, I was still in love with you.
Really, dear?
Of course.
I know it's hard for you to believe, but I never stopped loving you, either.
I do believe you. I didn't at first, but after Dr. Pedersen explained it to me.
Dr. Pedersen, who is he?
The famous psychiatrist. He said your trouble was your age. Lots of men who've been steady going and dependable all their lives act a little peculiar after they pass 40.
Ah, baloney. How's he know? He never saw me in his life.
Why, he doesn't have to see a person to tell. He's an authority on human behavior.
Well, that's ridiculous. There was nothing wrong with my behavior.
You just didn't realize it, darling. He says it comes on so gradually, a man doesn't know it.
What comes on?
Your second childhood.
That is a big lie. Why, the man is obviously a quack. I'll tell you what was the matter. We were in a rut. You were beginning to get on my nerves, and I...
You didn't think you'd say things like this. Or I'd never have consented to meet you tonight. Why, I've been able to afford more and better clothes on the separation settlement you're paying me than I ever could when I was living with you. I have more time to devote to things I enjoy. More invitations to shows, parties, weekends. I'm living at a hotel where somebody else has to fret about the servants and the marketing. I get my breakfast served to me in bed. I have hours to fritter away every day in beauty parlors, dress shops, or just gadding.
Why, Susie.
I haven't had a worry or care since our separation. So you don't think I'm going back to that humdrum rut, do you?
Humdrum? Susie, don't you love me anymore?
I suppose so. But if I come back to you, Willie, it's going to be on my terms.
Your terms.
What are you going to do?
right back.
Havana.
Who?
I'll have him paged.
Paged, Mr. Morland.
Myrtle, will you get me Miami 46464, please?
Miami 46464. Okay, Jimmy, take booth one.
Hello? I'd like to speak to Captain Hagedorn, please. About the Dumont case.
He didn't give his name, but he wants to talk to you about the Dumont murder.
Okay, Casey. Hagedorn speaking.
I have some information about the Dumont case.
Well, what is it?
I can break Joe Reed's alibi.
Sure about that? Yeah? Saw him coming down the fire escape. What time was that? Yeah, that checks. Why don't you come in and tell me all about it?
I'm not coming anyplace till Joe Reed's in jail. I'm not taking a chance on his finding out that I put the finger on him.
Oh, okay. Supposing I make a deal with you. I'll pick Reed up tonight, and then you come in later and tell us the whole story. Swell. He's at the Club Havana now, huh? That'll save us the trouble of looking for him. You sure you don't want to give us your name? Okay. Well, I'll pick Reed up within the hour. See you later.
Thanks, Myrtle.
Club Havana. Table for three. What's the name, please? Yes, Mr. Story, thank you. Reservation. And page Joe Reed.
Another reservation. I have a call for Mr. Reed.
Over there.
Did you phone the police?
Yeah. I hope they get here in a hurry. Look, Isabelita. I think you got a phone call. I don't like the looks of it.
Relax, I'll be right back.
Joe, you're in trouble.
Yeah?
That phone call was just a stall. You've got to get out of here fast.
What are you talking about?
I listened in on a call to the police. They're coming for you.
Who made the call?
Jimmy Medford, the piano player. He says he saw you up at Julia Dumont's place. He wouldn't give them his name, and he won't talk until they jail you.
Okay, baby.
Joe, it's not true. You weren't with her, were you?
Of course not. The guy's crazy.
There wasn't anything between you and Julia, was there, Joe? Tell me the truth.
I said there wasn't. How many times do I have to tell you?
Sure, Joe. You've got to get away. I'll give that girl some excuse.
Forget it. I'm in the clear. And don't worry about that girl either. She doesn't mean a thing.
They never do mean a thing, do they, Joe?
I got to make a call. Get me in Miami, 88427.
Sure.
Hmm? Hello, Ace. Get over to Club Havana right away. Meet me at the beach. Yeah, I'll be waiting for you. Okay.
What's the matter, Roz?
Hmm?
Are you all right?
We're all right, Tom.
Are you sure?
I guess the champagne's gone to my head. I'm all right, see?
You better not drink anymore, darling.
Well, Johnny Norton.
Oh, hello, Jeffries.
Mrs. Winnegar, Mr. Jeffries.
How do you do?
Stroke of luck finding you here, Johnny. I tried to reach you today about the Maxwell deal.
Oh, yes. Anything new on that?
Can I see you alone?
Sure.
Do you mind, Ross?
Go ahead.
Good night, Mr. Lenniger.
Sure the kid saw you.
Agadon's on his way when out to grab me.
It's a rough break, Joe. The kid testifies you're nailed.
The cops don't know who the kid is.
I don't get it.
Well, he put the finger on me over the phone, said he wouldn't sing until they pinch me.
Yeah?
There's a grand in it for you.
There's an awful lot of heat on you right now, Joe.
Make it two.
Pick up $5,000 tomorrow.
Okay.
How I know?
Get at the bar. I'll spot him for you.
Okay, Joe.
Bésame, bésame mucho, como si fuera esta noche la última vez. Bésame mucho, que tengo miedo perderte, perderte después. Quiero tenerte muy cerca, mirarme en tus ojos, estar junto a ti. Piensa que tal vez mañana me encuentre muy lejos de ti. Bésame, bésame mucho, como si fuera esta noche la última vez. Perderte, perderte después. Bésame, bésame mucho. Each time I cling to your kiss, I hear music divine. Bésame mucho. Hold me, my darling, and say that you'll always be mine. This joy is something new, my arms enfolding you. Never knew this thrill before. Whoever thought I'd be holding you close to me, whispering, see why I adore it, dearest one. If you should leave me, each little dream would take wing and my life would be
back, honey. Isabelita, my name's Reed. I throw some parties every now and then, like to have some of my friends here. You could make yourself some extra change after hours.
Oh, thanks.
Well, no, think it over. You too.
Yeah. I almost went limp.
Jimmy, I don't like it.
I don't either.
Good evening, Captain.
Sorry to barge in like this, Charles, but we've got business here.
I see.
I've got to pick somebody up, but I'll do it with the least possible disturbance.
Thank you, Captain.
I understand Joe Reed is here.
Yes, he is.
Kelly, you better stand by the door there.
Yes, sir.
Swanson, you cover me.
Right.
Callahan, I think that call came from here. See what you can find out from her. Hello, Reed.
Hi. Sit down, have a drink, Captain.
It's just the same. I haven't time. I'll bring a guy in for questioning.
I see. What about?
An alibi?
Can the guy phone his lawyer?
Do that from headquarters.
Drive my car home, honey. I'll pick it up tomorrow. Let's go.
That's over.
Are you still going through with it, Jimmy?
Yeah, as soon as the club closes.
I don't like the idea of you carrying a gun. There's no need for it now.
Okay, I'll get rid of it.
No, I'll get rid of it. Then I'll be sure. Here, put it in my bag.
The phone operator doesn't know a thing, Chief.
Stick around with Swanson.
Roz. What's wrong, Roz?
Nothing wrong, John.
Come on, darling. You'd better get home.
Roz.
Try to walk. We're leaving now.
Yes, John.
Something is wrong.
Don't be cross with me, Johnny. It's so much easier this way. Just a beautiful drowsiness and sleep.
What is it, Miss Lott? Get a doctor quickly. Certainly, at once. Take her to my office. Pardon me, Dr. Porter?
Yes.
One of my patrons is ill. I'm sorry to impose on you like this.
That's quite all right. Glad to be of service.
Maybe I can help.
This way, Doctor. She's in my office.
I'm Hetty. Mr. Charles thought you might need some help.
I will in just a minute. Mr. Norton, you happen to know if Mrs. Lineker's been under a doctor's care recently?
Well, I don't think so. Why?
She appears to be under the influence of some sedative. You didn't happen to see her take anything within the past hour.
Why, no.
Is that her handbag?
Yes.
May I look in it, please?
Of course.
Mm-hmm. Powerful sleeping drug.
Mrs. Cavendish's sleeping pills. She must have picked them up in the powder room.
Get me a quart of strong black coffee.
Yes, Doctor.
Do everything possible, Doctor.
I will. Mr. Norton, I think you'd better go back to your table.
Yeah. And you too, Lucy.
You're keeping informed?
Certainly.
Thank you.
Come along, Mr. Norton.
Can I show you to your table?
Thank you. It's right over here. I don't think you need to worry, Mr. Norton. Bill's a very fine doctor. Tired.
Just try a little longer. You're doing fine.
Is Mrs. Lineker all right?
You may go to her now.
Thank you. Will you excuse me?
I don't want to. Don't you understand?
I understand perfectly. But what you tried to do never solves any problem. It only complicates them for those you leave behind. You have no right to destroy life, even your own.
Oh, Mr. Norton, come in.
Thank you.
Well, Mrs. Lineker can go home now, but I recommend a long walk out of doors first.
I hardly know how to express my gratitude, Doctor. I don't know what would have happened if you hadn't been here tonight.
Don't mention it. I'm glad I was here.
Thanks for everything.
You're welcome. Good night, Mrs. Winokur.
Good night.
You wanted to see me, Mr. Robert?
Yes, Charles.
Yes, Charles. Put the check on my account.
Thank you, madame.
And would you send us a statement of my...
As you wish, Mr. Rogers.
Yes, Charles. Please do. Come, children. Put on your coats.
My dear,
I should have met you sooner. Much sooner.
Cliffy. Looks like everybody's going home. Is it that late?
I'm afraid it is. I guess I spoiled your evening.
I enjoyed every minute of it.
A doctor never knows when he'll be called upon. His life isn't his own.
I can see that.
Shall we go now?
Thanks, honey.
I better get down to police headquarters.
I'm going with you.
Now look, Isabel.
There's no use arguing.
Okay.
Doctor, I want to thank you again for your courtesy.
Don't mention it.
I hope you'll both come again soon and be my guests.
Thank you, Mr. Charles. We'd be happy to.
Ah.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night,
girl.
Good night.
Good night.
Good night, girl.
Good night, Myrtle.
What's the matter, Myrtle?
I must see Jimmy Medford. Has he left yet?
He didn't come out this way. Try the back entrance.
Thanks.
Good night, Mr. Charles.
Myrtle was just looking for you, Jimmy. You can catch her if you hurry.
Oh, thanks.
Good night.
Good night.
She wants.
I don't know. Jimmy, look out!
coroner's wagon, Swanson. She's dead. Come on.
What about Myrtle? Is she all right?
No. Well, that poor kid, she saved our lives.
So you're the one who called Captain Hagedorn?
Yeah.
That guy Myrtle ran down was Joe Reed's gunman. Next time, you'd better tell the police who you are. It's a lot safer.
I've learned my lesson.
Better come along to headquarters with us now.
We were just going there.
You stay here, Swanson, and take care of things.
Right. Look at me, darling.
I didn't think I'd ever have to face you.
You almost didn't. I almost lost you. Darling, I've lived a lifetime in the last few minutes. I won't forget it.
I'm sorry it was so messy.
It never happened. Come on, dear. We're both awake now. Now for a nice long walk.
Together?
Yes, dear. Always together.